lawyers, and well, you know what? They will all pile off to exactly the wrong people at exactly the wrong time. And they'll do it every time. And they can all take an enormous beating. Yet still drag themselves out the other side and continue pursuing their goal. And that was those were the basic character traits I put together for the resident. And so there you go. Kind of a long answer.
Well, the history of Colin Murphy ever really, how he killed himself, his legacy as were, will that ever really come out? Will it be important in any way?
Will the history of Colin Murphy, how he killed himself, etc., come out? Will it be important in any way? Well, no. I mean, because that would require that he actually killed himself. So I'll leave it at that. right here, in his armchair.
What do you feel is your biggest cliche?
What do I feel is my biggest cliche? And what, to repeat your question, what do I feel is my biggest avoidance of cliche? There's far fewer of those. The Wizard of Fireball is probably it. I try not to, but I played so much D&D when I was young. You know, that basically it's going to happen. I try to avoid it, but not. Although I have had fun playing with fireballs in like the same way we used to do in all the old D&D games. It's a 3,000 cubic feet of fire. Now you've got to understand where the 10x10 hall is. It's this wrong. Why are you blowing down the gate with that crap? Yeah, but I'm in a room of kids. let's go over right here in our black and red.
Will we ever see Dresden maybe forced into a situation where he may have to jump through time to reverse something?
Will we ever see Dresden forced into a situation where he may have to jump through time to do something? That would require him breaking one of the laws of magic. And it's not as though I have 7 books outlined, one for each law or anything. I'm just saying, we may probably, possibly see some such thing at some point. Over here to black. Am I right that I can have a short story crossing Dresden over into another universe, like Star Wars, Doctor Who, something like that? No, because I don't want to get sued. However, just so you're aware, the Dresden Files universe exists in a big, wide spectrum multiverse. So we're there. You know, it's not like there's parallel Earth. There's an entire, you know, there's an entire broadband spectrum of parallel Earth. And if you go far enough, you'll find the parallel Earth where Spider-Man is. You'll find the parallel Earth where Summer War stuff works. Dresden could get there if you really, really wanted to, but stop and think about that for a minute. I mean, would you really want to go to the Star Wars universe? Because you're not going to be a Jedi over there. They're probably pretty good. And, you know, really, Jedi are a whole lot scarier from ground level than they are from the, you know, passenger seat next to one. You know, there's a bunch of deadly armamentic mind control powers here. They didn't want to talk to you. That's kind of spooky.
The RPG actually mentioned that you could have different dresses based on different
choices
he's had in
the
past book.
Is
that just for the RPG, or
are
we
actually going to
maybe see some of those in the story?
The RPG mentioned that you can have different dresses based upon, you know, you can create different ones in the game based upon different choices he's made in the past books. And is that for the RPG only? No, they came up with that because they know that I'm using that in the storyline in the future. I mean, because I've said several times it's only going to be a matter of time before I can just do a Mirror Mirror episode of the Dresden Files. In fact, I think I'm just going to call it Mirror Mirror. Because come on, that's a great title. It's the same number of letters in it. My work is done. I'm down with that. I like it when you know, it's already done. in the very back end, why?
I was wondering, in one book, I believe Bob mentioned the Jenny Ford vampires, will that ever come up, or?
Will the Jenny Ford vampires ever come up? They might briefly come up in the big finale, on account of they are in China, and they are, isolationists, and they stay isolated. There's a gang of Chinese vampires that, are good to be joined with. I saw Princess Bride recently, so. if the bunch of Princess Bride references so good tonight, I'm sorry. It was on TV, and, I can't help it. Over here, Blue. Okay, as an author, when did I know that Maggie existed? 503.
Wow.
503, I was like, oh, wait a minute, okay, yeah, I'm going to have to do this, because I remember there being some huge, there was some huge uproar on the list, and I was still kind of keeping track of things at the time, and, because, man, there's nothing that will get me riled up faster than, a discussion on the internet. But there was somebody going on, and somebody was upset about Paul Hamilton's books and trying to get panic on, they were all standing with the argument that, hey, these books have evolved into nothing but BDSM sex, there's nothing to do with plot. And then someone was countering with that, goes, how could he possibly have a BDSM sex scene that was actually plot relevant? And I went, oh, my very business was planned. The specifics didn't get settled until a little later, but her very business was in book three. It was about where I figured it out. But, right away. Okay, great powerful wizards are stable, but he said his statement is that, generally speaking, these big powerful wizards, by the time they get to the end, what they actually do accomplish in terms of the big finale of the series is fairly small. And am I planning something like that for Dresden? Yes and no, is the answer to that. The problem with most of the wizards that do that is simply, they aren't the central character of the series. Gandalf, not the central character of the series, that was Sam. Not Frodo, who was not the central character. Frodo is a junkie who was along for the ride. Sam is the man. It's similar with classical wizards with characters like Merlin. Arthur's the center of that story for the most part. Oh, there is Merlin's story, so on. But am I gonna go all the way to the end of this to have Dresden be the one who, pushes the button and says, destroy the universe? Yes, no. It's not gonna be anywhere near that simple. Hopefully, if I do it right, which I don't know because I've never written a 20-book epic fantasy before. hopefully, if I do it right, we'll set it up to where if it had been anybody else, it would have been a disaster. Because it's Dresden, we all just keep getting along. If you're doing your job as a writer, by the time you get to end of your story, any other individual other than that character who makes things happen, if somebody else had been there, it all would have been horribly wrong. If you're doing your job right, hopefully I'll be able to do the same thing. But like I said, it's big. I've never written a story like that before. In the loop.
What sort of thing, if you could go back to the first and second novel, would you like to say the house shall curve you, like the sun and the agate, and the wool, iron?
Oh, what things would I go back in the earlier novels to change, tell things now? I would probably scrap the first two books completely and rewrite from the ground up everything about it, which would probably be a disaster. I learned that going back and rewriting a novel doesn't work anywhere near as well as you think it should. So at this point, I'm happy to accept the flaws and imperfections from early on because it just means, oh, wait a minute, now I have a good direction to go to keep things moving the way I want them to go. You know, I probably would never have figured out that wizards, you know, the whole thing about them recovering from injury, it has a lot to do with them living a long time. They've got a group, far grouper telomeres than any of us have. Their DNA copy works better than ours does. I probably wouldn't have figured that out if somebody hadn't pointed out, hey, I've been keeping track of the books, I'm a physical therapist, and I just wanted to let you know that in the past 5 years, Dresden has aggregated about 7.5 years of therapy. And you really need to be aware that this injury would require this kind of surgery, and then this kind of recovery, and then another surgery to correct that, and still more therapy. And, you know, by the time we get to that, he's already been busted up by the next book, which would have done this and that. I mean, okay, so obviously, wizards are cooler than that. Okay, that's why, and that's a good reason. You know, why they live, that's why they live a long time, too. Awesome. This is working out great. As long as I can stay on my mental toes, I guess we'll be all right.
My question is, has any of your characters surprised you or done something you weren't expecting them to do, develop a certain way?
Okay, have any of my characters surprised me or done something I wasn't expecting them to do or develop the way I didn't want them to go? Those people work for me. Occasionally they are irascible, and I have to make sure to give them good motivations to do the things that I need them to do. And occasionally they just kind of come out cooler than I thought they would be. Butters is just going to be my kind of off the wall one shot. I want to put an end with a sense of humor because I really like those characters. You know, I've seen Relic, I've seen Prophecy, and those characters are fun. Which, if you haven't seen those movies, no, I'll go back because that means they're more hilarious. You know, after I wrote it, I'm like, okay, this guy is just so zany, I've got to use him again somewhere, because I hadn't really planned it. I hadn't planned Butters at all. I just said, oh, I need an enemy here. I need an enemy with a sense of humor. Okay, I need a guy, okay, I built this guy together real quick, you know, in 20 minutes while I was watching the end of probably a Star Wars movie, and said, okay, let's go, and wrote him. But it's not so neat. I'm like, okay, I've got to use him again. I've got to find a good place to have this guy. And figured, you know, what better sidekick for a wizard going up against a gang of necromancers from enemy to dead than a medical examiner whose job is to deal with them all the time? Yet there would be absolutely no real health in any profession. I always like to plan things for Dresden and all like that. Well, how do I give them a sidekick? They'll be great comfort with the medical appropriate, yet not actually offer it to any true assistance. But that's just kind of how he rolls. In the back of the black shirt, please. I can pick any actor to play Harry and Thomas. Who would I pick? Oh, man. I'd probably pick a mid-1970s Harrison Ford for Harry. Because I'm happy to pick actors from other times who can't possibly get. It's only a matter of time before technology makes that possible. Or we can actually have a 1970s Harry Fisher star across from the 1955 John Wayne. It will happen one day. But if I had to pick someone who's actually working now, I'd probably go with Captain Titan for Harry. And he would be fine. As far as Thomas, that's a harder call. Thomas in my head is the older brother from Lost Boys. Jason, what's his name?
Okay.
Yeah, Jason Patrick. He doesn't look at him anymore. I might also go with the guy who played Bryce in the first couple of seasons of Chuck. Was actually very close to Thomas in my head, except his hair was too short. But other than that, he's pretty close. And now everybody's going, huh? Who? How? I